afternoon to all of you. I hereby extend a hearty welcome to all participants logged to the online lecture on personal and civic hygiene as a part of the observance of Swachhata Pakhwada. You may be aware that the Government of India has directed all schools to observe Swachhata Pakhwada to promote the activities of Swachh Bharat Mission. Inculcation of sound practices of civic and personal hygiene in students is a very important step towards making India a cleaner and more livable one. The speakers of today's session are Dr. Ashwini Pillai and Dr. Divya Naik. Dr. Ashwini Pillai is a doctor who specializes in head and neck pathology and also in pain and palliative care. She has successfully led campaigns to spread awareness about the prevention of cancer, has led numerous sessions on anti-tobacco and substance abuse, and has led a number of community hygiene initiatives by Tata Institute of Social Science, Mumbai. She was attached to the Department of Pain and Palliative Care at Tata Memorial Hospital and BARC Hospital. Dr. Divya did primary and secondary education from our school, Atomic Energy Center School 2, Mumbai, in 2005, and her 12th from Atomic Energy Junior College in 2007 after standing first in Science Stream. After doing her degree from Mumbai, she stood second in Maharashtra Common Entrance Test and completed her post-graduation in prosthodontics from Government Dental College, Nagpur. She had worked as an assistant professor at Government Dental College, Mumbai, and runs her own practice, besides training undergraduate students. Both of these doctors are involved in many community outreach programs among weaker and economically disadvantaged sections of society in and around our Anushakti Nagar. Now, I cordially invite our principal, Dr. B. Venkanna, to formally inaugurate this online program. Sir, please.
Good afternoon, everyone. After a long time, we are able to interact with each other. Sometimes my video may not be coming. It is showing poor video quality. But anyway, I will try to continue. It's a part of the system you all know. We listen from various personalities regarding our educational objectives and the other activities other than academics. So it would be definitely helpful to our children and parents and the staff members. And it's equally thrilling to know that one of our ex-students of alumni of AES is now today will be interacting with the children of our school. And definitely the children will take the benefit out of her words. And I once again welcome Dr. Ashwini. And if any children must put down if any queries are there, and they should post the queries, and the queries will be clarified. And I once again welcome all of you, the children, and I wish the program will be a successful one. And you please start. Dr.
Salman. Yes. I heartily welcome Dr. Ashwini and Dr. Divya to deliver the lecture on personal and civic hygiene. Ma'am, please.
I hope I'm audible to all of you. Am I audible? Can you just put your thumb up if I'm audible? Am I audible? Okay, fine. So, I'm very happy, to be a part of this program. Okay, and a very good afternoon to all of you. Really appreciable if you all keep your cameras on. I know there are some network issue even in between. Even I am not able to hear, or there are some lags and all that. But then we'll do it. We'll do it as good as possible. Okay, with all this technical glitch. Fine. So. You all know, why we have come back over here, and I know you all are very tired after your classes, after your lunch. And I'm so glad that you all have taken some time in between to come and sit over here and listen to what we want to talk to you. But let me tell you one thing. I don't want both of us, me and Divya, both of us don't want to give a long speech and put you in trouble. Okay, so I always liked an interactive session, but I know that we have some limitations because it's an online thing, but we'll do as interesting as possible. So just chill. You just have to hear and you just have to respond. I always love to be interacting, and I'm so glad to see your beautiful faces in the screen. That made my day. Okay, so can we start? So I'll be actually speaking about personal hygiene. So I believe that about when it comes to hygiene or when it comes to cleanliness, yes, you need to clean your surroundings, and also you need to take some effort to keep yourself healthy and hygienic, right? You can shake your head. Okay, so that all of you are very good. So can I do it with a PPT? It'll be easier for you. I've put some photos and all that. We'll all have a good time. Okay, can we do that? Fine, let me just share.
You can add and you can interact.
No, ma'am.
Can you?
Is
okay. Maybe because of the net, Okay. So if you cannot see the PPT, you can just listen to me. Can you see me at least?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, we can see you.
Okay.
Yes, teacher.
Okay. So we'll start our. We'll talk. Okay. So. Once again, good afternoon to all of you. I'm really happy to see your happy faces. Nice, beautiful, sunny face. Okay? Can all of you give me a smile? A broad, good smile? Very good. That's nice. Arya, your smile is very sweet. Huh? I can see Arya, on the screen. I can see only very few people when I'm presenting. So that is why I picked up Arya's smile. And Divya, yours also.
Thank you.
So do you know what hygiene is? We all talk a lot about being hygiene, be hygienic, keep your hygiene, practice your hygiene. So do you know what is hygiene? So hygiene, it's a Greek word. Okay, just like any other tough words. So any tough words are from Greek or Latin. Okay, so hygiene is, it's a Greek word, which means it's goddess of health. Okay, which means being healthy or sound. Now, what is personal hygiene? Basically, what you need to be clean. Your body needs to be clean so that you will have a healthy body, right? So, right today, when we're talking about hygiene, we would be talking about this. Hygiene is a very common word. And we have a personal hygiene and an environmental hygiene. So, I'm going to talk to you, or we are going to just discuss about the personal hygiene. Okay, now what is personal hygiene? What is personal hygiene? It's a hygiene about keeping your hair properly, your face, your skin, your hands, your feet, your private parts, keeping it clean. In fact, the whole body clean.
Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. There was some problem with the mic.
Can we continue?
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
We were talking about.
I'm sure.
Okay. So why? Because there is a lot of dust entering your nose, and this mucus covers it, and that is why it is a sticky slime. Tiny thing, and it starts getting dry. So that is when you feel the irritation and you feel like picking up nose. But I would say that try to avoid this. Let's call it, it's full of germs.
dust and mucus. So every time you feel like doing it, what you need to do is, it's very simple, okay? Every time you want to pick plaque, what you need to do is that take a tissue paper or a kerchief and clean your nose, go to the washroom, clean your nose and come back. Okay, so all of you will remember this, right? Whenever you want to, you have that urge to pick your nose, you all should do this, okay? Because it has germs, it has dust, and also remember that your hands are very dirty and you're putting your hands in your nose. Is it good? Is it the right thing to do? No, right? Shake your head so that I can see you all. Yeah, so it's not good. It's not good to do that. It's full of germs and you have germs in your hand that also will enter into your nose. And you know what all comes when germs enter your mouth, right? You know about corona, right? We all know about corona, what happens. So you shouldn't be touching, I mean your hands should not touch in any part, neither your eyes nor your nose, your ears or your mouth, unless and until your hands are clean. Okay? So this is what you all need to do. Now about coughing and sneezing. Is this a good practice to do? You all are standing together in the playground. When someone of you wants to cough or a sneeze, what do? Just do it, right? Is that what you're supposed to do? No. You're supposed to cover your face, exactly. So I'll just pick one of you. Atira V. Satish. So can you tell me, Atira, like how do you cough? Can you cough and show? Yes. And can you show how you sneeze? Can you show me how you sneeze? Yes, that is how she did it, like this, right? So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to show you an alternative method, a better method to do that. So whenever you want to cough or sneeze, you, if you have a kerchief, you can use a kerchief and do this. Okay. Or you can do that. But every time when you want to sneeze, there will not be a kerchief in your hand. So what is the best thing to do? You can use this part of your hand where it is much cleaner than your hands. So your hands are dirty. What are you doing? You're going to put it on your face and do. So what happens? Again, your hands are getting even more dirtier, and then you're going to touch here and there. You're going to hold your friend's hand. You're going to touch your food. That's not good, right? So what can you do about that? You can use your inner part of your elbow. Can you all see this? Can you all see this place? Yeah. You have to do. This is much more hygienic. Huh? This is a better way to do. See, you can cover it up like this. Or you can use a handkerchief or a tissue paper if you have one handy. But not otherwise. When there is nothing in your hand, you need to do this. Okay? You'll all do this, no? You all agree with me, right? What do you do if you are smelling bad? You need to take bath. You all know that, right? I don't have to tell you when you have to take bath. Try to take bath 2 times a day. Take a shower 2 times a day. See, there are some places in the world where they don't have to do it because it's all dry and cold. So you need to take a shower 2 times a day, especially if you are staying in a place which is hot and humid. Okay, so I'll quickly go to some other stuff. You need to change your undergarments regularly. Okay, you need to wash, wear clean and washed clothes and dry. It should be dry. You shouldn't be washing smelly clothes again and again. And then clean and change your socks regularly. Now, why do I tell all this? Why is it necessary that, you know, you need to be dry? You need to change your cloth. You need to change your undergarments every now and then. Why do I tell that? Okay. So, can you tell me what is this? Yeah, tell me. Abhishek, tell me. It's a piece of bread, right? Yes, it's a piece of bread. So, I think you're all 5th standard and 6th standard students. Do you know what happens when you keep bread in a moist, dark place for 2-3 days? What happens? Can someone tell me that? What happens? Yes, I can see some people say that this happens, right? What is this? This is mold, or we call it fungus, right? So the same thing happens to our body. So when does it happen? And where, you know, how does it happen? When your body is always wet, like say for example, you are a person who takes bath regularly 2 times a day, but then you don't make it dry. Okay, you just wear your clothes and go to school. So what happens? So there are some parts of our body which is in dark, which is like, you know, really like close. For example, your armpits, your private parts, in between your toes, toe fingers, you know, in between your toes. These are the areas where there is a lot of, you know, wetness will stay there for hours. And whenever there is a wetness, whenever there is a moist or a moisture is there, fungus tends to grow there. So you might be thinking, "Arey, kitne baar maine aise sab kiya? Abhi tak kuch fungus nahi dekha." It's not like that. Our body has got immunity; it will fight, but it may not be able to fight always. So it's very important to keep your body parts dry after you clean. I mean, so even a wet socks, you get sweat, socks will become wet, and the next day you put it back in your shoe. Again, you have what happened? Again, you wear the same wet socks with the, you know, with your sweat and dirt and everything. So that can give you fungus. So you know how a fungal infection looks like? It's really bad. It's really, really bad. See this guy, I think he have never even, you know, cleaned, you know, dried his back after, you know, probably taking bath. He might never have dried up. That is why he got a fungal infection. Right? So you all got why I'm telling you to dry. Wear dry clothes. Change your, you know, because when you go, each time when you go to your toilet, your undergarments get wet. You shouldn't be wearing it again. You should make sure that your undergarments are always dry. And especially, preferably dried up in sun. Even after washing, even after taking it out from the washing machine, or even if after you wash it with hands, it should be dried in sun, under the sun, preferably. If no sun, somehow you can iron it. It's a very good practice. Ironing your undergarments is a very good practice. Ironing your socks is a very good practice. Discuss about these things with your parents also. You all know this. Trimming the nails of hands and feet. It's very important because there's a lot of your nail. And you eat with the same hand. So it's very important. Now this is the last part of the slide where I wanted to just mention about hand washing. You all know how important it is to hand wash your hands after you come back to your home, after before you eat. Every now and then, now for the last 1 year, we all have got that practice of washing your hands, right? We all wash our hands very frequently. But how to wash your hands? So this time, I want all of you who are listening to me to do it along with me. Can you all do that? Yes. So we'll all wash hands. It's imaginative, okay? So we are going to open the, what are we going to do first? We are going to on the pipe, right? We are going to on the pipe. Chalo, we'll on the pipe. I'm going to on the pipe. Okay, so there is water. I'm going to wet my hand, right? All of you are doing with me, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, so the hands are wet. Now, what I'm going to do is that, put soap on my hand. See, I press the soap. So there is soap in my hand. I'm going to do this. So first is palm to palm. Second is between the fingers. Can you do this? Between the fingers. Step 2. Now the step 3 is back of your hand. Both your hands, right? Yeah. Both your hands. Then, this is very important. When we do like this, we are missing this guy over here. Which is this guy? Your thumb. So, what are we doing? We're doing this. See what we're doing. You're going to clean your thumb. Can you see me doing this? Yes. Then, at the back of your finger, you can hold it like a chain. See, you can hold it like a chain. You can hold it like this. Both your hands. Can you see that? And you can clean your fingernails. There are a lot of germs here because you pick everything. You push the lift button. You take things with the, you know, you pick up the things like this. So there are a lot of germs at the tip of your finger. So you're doing this. both your hands. Okay? And then finally the wrists. So over here, till here, you need to keep it clean. And then wash it again under water on the pipe. Wash it. Wash it nicely. Then rinse and dry your hands. Is it clear, all of you?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, teacher.
So you all have learned how to do the hand wash technique, right?
Yes,
ma'am.
Yes. So that is about personal hygiene. I hope you all had a good time. Now, what I want to tell you is that, as I said, the hygiene part doesn't limit to your body. You are being well groomed. You are all dressed up. And what if you're going to throw your, your napkins or your chips packet, on the floor? Is that hygienic? Is that cleanliness? No. Right? So, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to ask somebody. Okay, there is somebody in this group who has been. Okay, before that, let me ask you. How many years you want to know how your ACS school looks after 10 years? Interesting. After 10 years or 15 years, when you are going, when you are doing some work, do you want to come back and see how ACS 2 looks like?
Yes, ma'am.
No, Adarsh doesn't want to look. See how school looks. How many of you want to see? You're big people, okay? You're big people. You're working and all that. Yes, we all want to see our school, how it looks like. We want to see how, whether our old teachers are there or not. We want to go and hug them, talk to them, right? We all want to do that. Yes. And then, what if we want to, what if we want to share? What if you guys want to share to that time students? I mean, after 15 years, there will be some students in ACS too, right? So, you want to talk to them about how it was, how good ACS was, how good the teachers were, how did you study? Did you study well or you used to get less marks? It's okay. Right? You would like to share all that, right? And there is somebody in this group who can share all that to you, who have come to see you all after many, many years. Okay? That is Dr. Divya. She has been a student of the school, and I don't want to talk more because Divya has got a lot of things to share with you guys.
Ma'am, she was a student.
She's coming, she was a previous student. Yes, she was a student of your school. Just be excited to listen to her, okay?
Hello. Can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, doctor.
Hi, how are you? Please don't call me doctor. It's very weird. Okay. So I was a student of ACS 2 and I was there for 11 years. Right from KG till my 10th standard, I was a student at ACS 2. After passing out from ACS 2, I have gone to so many places. I've studied at multiple universities. And I've seen so many, but ACS 2 is still my, this school, it gave me so much knowledge, it gave me so much confidence, it taught me so much, I met so many wonderful teachers. I'm extremely happy that I'm here, and I'm so surprised that there are 97 participants in this meeting, but I'll just start. Today I'm going to talk about civic hygiene. You know what civic hygiene means? Can you see this? Is this visible?
Yes, teacher.
Hey, don't call me teacher. I'm not a teacher. Yeah, anyways, so let's begin, okay? So Anushakti Nagar, right? So I lived in Anushakti Nagar for 27 years. Okay, I moved here when I was 2 years old and I moved out in 2019. Now, those of you who are good at mathematics can figure out my age. But anyways, so Anushakti Nagar, right? So for 27 years, we stayed here and I did all my education till 12th standard at Anushakti Nagar, right? We used to have these wide roads, so clean, you wouldn't find a paper piece anywhere. isn't it? And that's our school. Our school that used to be like I told you, my favorite place. Apart from school, I used to come here to learn Bharatanatyam also. You know, my sir was Guru, was Srinivas Guru at that. I don't know if he's still teaching there, but I learned Bharatanatyam at the school. And very, very good memories. But you know, in 2007, which is when I started studying dentistry, I started doing my bachelor's of dental surgery. That is when I moved out of my colony for the first time, you know. And when I moved, I was very excited because you live your entire life in the colony. You really want to see what Mumbai is and you want to go everywhere. And I had that freedom finally, you know. But what I saw when I moved out of the colony was very shocking. Isn't it? Because we are used to seeing these very clean, wide roads, lush greenery, and like spick and span places. And when you go out in the city, you are so disappointed because all you can see is trash and garbage everywhere. Isn't it? So it was quite disappointing for me to see that. And I remember I used to travel by train a lot, you know, by local train. And every single day in the local train, I would see some lady throwing out a piece of paper or throwing a bag of flowers into the sea. You know, when we used to go to Vashi, they'll throw a bag of flowers into the sea. And sometimes it used to really bother me. So sometimes I used to ask them, "Are you fake rahe ho karke?" But you know what it is, they start fighting with you. You know, so then I stopped asking. But then one day, you know. But that led me to think a lot about why we need to keep our surroundings clean. I mean, we keep ourselves clean, that is fine, right? I mean, because we want to be clean, we want to appear, we want to be healthy. But is that enough? Is keeping ourselves healthy and ourselves clean enough? Because see, we are very fortunate people because we have a beautiful colony, a beautiful school to go to that is clean and neat and everything. But there are many, many, many thousands of children, little children who are not that fortunate, isn't it? So why is it important for us to not just take care of our personal hygiene, but to also maintain our surroundings in a clean state, our city in a clean state? Because there are so many millions of children who are in need of clean surroundings, isn't it? And the biggest reason is because there are so many diseases that one can get because of poor sanitation and poor surroundings, like diarrhea, dysentery, cholera, malaria, dengue, right? You know how cholera was discovered? So this is almost 150 years back, you know, in the 1800s. There was this doctor, his name was Dr. Snow. Right? And this is in England, okay? So what had happened is that there was this one region of England where a lot of children started getting sick. Not just children, even adults, right? They started getting sick, they started falling sick, they started getting fever and dehydration, a lot of dysentery, and they were not able to figure out why this is happening and how this is happening. And the doctors, and there were a lot of deaths, people started dying. So what Dr. Snow did is, you know what? He took a map of London, right? He took a map of the city, a big map. And then he started marking out every neighborhood or every house in which there had been a death or there had been someone who was sick, you know. And this way he made a lot of dots. And then once all the dots were marked, he observed the map and he noticed that all these dots were surrounding one particular well. You understanding? And then what they did is that they went and took water from that well and they tested it. And that is when they discovered the bacteria which causes this cholera. And that is when cholera was actually discovered. And that is when they could fight it. And what they realized is that, do you know what sewage is? Sewage is, so when you go to the toilet and you flush, right? So all that dirty water with urine and excreta and everything, where does that go? That is called sewage, the dirty water, no, that is called sewage. Now, normally in big cities, so London is a huge city, right? So normally in big cities, what happens? All this dirty water, no, it goes from your flush, it is taken into huge pipes, it is treated a little and it is taken into a water body. Now that water body, for us, it is Arabian Sea, right? It is thrown into the Arabian Sea. In places where there is no sea adjacent, it's not a coastal city, it's thrown into a river. So what had happened in this case, where Dr. Snow was residing, is that the sewage water was going into the river called Thames. You know, there's a river called, very famous river called Thames in England. So all that sewage water was going into Thames, and the same water was coming as drinking water to the city. And wherever that water supply was going, all the children were falling sick and they were dying. So that itself tells you the importance of keeping our surroundings clean. It is not enough to keep just our house clean or just our bodies clean, right? Each of us has to be responsible to take care that our surroundings are clean as well, isn't it? About dengue and malaria, too, you know only. Malaria is one of the... So when I was doing my bachelor's or master's degree and we were in the hospital, out of 20 patients, 18 patients would have malaria only. You realize? So you understand what is the gravity of the situation. So many people get malaria, but why does malaria occur? It occurs because of mosquitoes that breed in stagnant water, isn't it? So it is very, very important for us to ensure that there is no place around your building or in your house where water can collect and it can stay there. You understanding? That is stagnant water. Water collects somewhere and it stays there. It is in such water that you have mosquitoes or malaria and dengue. Okay. Now, yeah, like I was telling you, I used to travel in trains a lot, you know. And every day I would see people throwing things. And it used to bother me a lot, you know. I really wanted to tell them to not throw things. But, you know, I was 18, 19 year old. And then you tell someone and they get angry. And then there's a fight and nobody listens. So then I stopped telling people. So one day when I was traveling, you know, there was a lady sitting opposite me and she was eating vada pav. Right. She had like a newspaper and she had vada pav and she ate nicely. And then she crumpled up the newspaper and she was just going to throw it out of the window. So I stopped her. And I told her, auntie, dustbin mein dal do na. So she's like, where is the dustbin? So I said, every station has dustbin, so you can throw it in the dustbin. So she said, no, I don't want to keep it with me. It's dirty and all that. So I told her, it's not much. You give it to me, I'll throw it. So she felt a little ashamed or something, you know. So she said, no, it's okay, I'll throw it. And then she started discussing with me. She said that even if we throw it outside, I'm just one person. No, if I throw one piece of paper, how does it matter? That is not going to make the city dirty. It's just one small piece of paper. But then you realize that, so you know what the population of Mumbai is? Mumbai, the population of Mumbai is more than 19 million, right? We have more than 19 million Mumbaikars. Now, if each one of the 19 million Mumbaikars think that I'll throw one piece of paper, we'll have 19 million pieces of paper. And that is how the city becomes dirty, isn't it? And it is not enough to think that there is some kachrawala who will pick up my trash. There is some official who will pick up my trash. I am responsible for my trash. If I ask you to go and pick up the trash that I have thrown, you won't want to pick it up, right? So if each one of us just tries to not litter by ourselves and not even tell others, just each one of us takes responsibility of our own trash, that itself will clean up our city and our country a lot. You know, now you all are 10 and 11 year olds, right? And y'all are basically children. You might think that, you know, I mean, the world is run by adults, isn't it? And you might think that nobody takes me seriously. My parents might listen to me probably. But how much difference can that make? You know, you might think what is in my hand? But there is actually a lot that is in our hands. You know, the first would be 3 R's, right? To reduce, to reuse and to recycle, right? What can you reduce? You can reduce using plastic bags. Isn't it? That was a whole, there was a whole movement some years back, isn't it? Wherein they were saying that plastic bags, you should not use plastic bags that much. Now, what is the problem with plastic? The problem with plastic is that it doesn't decompose. It doesn't spoil, right? A piece of plastic will stay for 1,000 years if you let it. It will never get spoiled, you know? So, if I am buying one plastic bag every day and I have 10 plastic bags, those 10 plastic bags will live longer than me, my children, my grandchildren, their grandchildren and their grandchildren and their grandchildren. You understanding? The life of plastic is a lot. And every time you buy a new plastic bag, you are increasing the waste on the planet and the burden on the planet, isn't it? So it is important to reduce our consumption. See, if you use one plastic, if I have a plastic bag for today, tomorrow I can use the same plastic bag. And for the 10 days, I can use the same plastic bag because plastic is going to stay like that only. There's nothing that is going to happen to plastic, isn't it? The second is to reuse. The plastic bags you can reuse. You can reuse hundreds of times. You can reuse the same plastic bag and nothing will happen. Understanding? And the second thing is you can recycle. You can, what do you mean by recycle? You know what recyclable things are? A lot of plastic bags. Do you see that sign? That photo with the girl on top, and there is a container that has a sign with three arrows in a triangle, isn't it? That is the sign that you will see on objects that can be recycled. So whenever you've bought something, whenever you have to throw something, just check for this sign. If the sign is present, that means that thing can be recycled. And you should give it for recycling, isn't it? That is how we'll reduce the burden that is already present on the planet. Of course, we can try to not make any more garbage, but we have to try to reduce what has already been made, no? Over so many years, we've created so much kachra that we have to think about reducing that and not making more, isn't it? So what can you do as kids, as you cannot really go and clean the entire city or the entire nation? We have a huge nation, isn't it? But what you can do is you can adopt a spot. Maybe, let's say I used to stay at Udaygiri. That was my last building. I've stayed in 5 buildings in the colony, starting with Nilgiri, then Akashganga, and then Ajanta, and then I also stayed at Ragmala and Ranjani, and then finally at Udaygiri for 11 years. So let's say I stay in Udaygiri, okay? And I had 3 of my very good friends also staying in Udaygiri. So if the 4 of us decide to take Udaygiri and let's say 100 meters around Udaygiri as our spot, you know, what we can do is we can make sure that this area that we have adopted remains clean, right? And just maybe one day a week, you can take one day a week, maybe a Sunday, right? Y'all can take 1 hour every Sunday. Y'all can come and just in your spot, whatever is your spot, you can move around. Whatever kachra you find, whatever garbage you find, you take it, you throw it in the dustbin. Isn't it? That itself, see, if every group of children or every child adopts one spot, however small it is, we end up cleaning the entire city, isn't it? Because we have many children. We have thousands and thousands of children in Mumbai, isn't it? The third thing is composting. Now, this is something that is very actively done in my own house. And I know a lot of families in Anushakti Nagar who are also doing this. You know what composting is? I don't know if you all been taught yet, but we were taught in EVS 2. But I don't remember which standard that was in. So, you all know the concept of wet waste and dry waste, isn't it? Wet waste is what? Anything that decomposes. Jo bhi sad sakta hai na, that is wet waste, right? So, anything in your kitchen, like let's say vegetable peels, right? If you've eaten something and thoda khana waste ho gaya, that. If you've kept some food and that has gotten spoiled, like the moldy bread that Ashruti ma'am showed you, right? That. Let's say if you're non-vegetarian, so if you've cleaned the fish, chicken bones, fish bones, all of these things are wet waste, right? What is dry waste? Dry waste is anything that is dry and doesn't spoil. Like what? Plastic. Plastic is the main dry waste. Let's say you've got a TV or a washing machine. Right, so the dabba jiske andar that TV came, then the thermocol packing, the thermocol that is used for packing, all that is dry waste, right? So let's say you have 2 dustbins in your house and you keep the wet waste separate and you keep the dry waste separate. Now the dry waste you have to send to the person who comes to collect your kachra. What do you do with the wet waste? Now at my house, you know what we do? We have a container. So we take some soil and we put all the wet waste that is produced in my house in that. Even chai patti, after you've had chai, so whatever is left, the tea powder, we put that also. And we mix it nicely with the soil. We cover it and we keep it. You know what happens? All this vegetable peel and all the wet waste is going to get decomposed. And what you get is fertilizer, is manure. And we have a lot of plants in our house, as do most families in Anushakti Nagar. You'll have a lot of plants in your house, right? So this manure is, you can use and you can put in the plants. It's very, very good food for the plants. You understanding? So this process is basic. There are many types of composting. Exactly, vermicomposting. You know, vermicomposting, they use a type of worm, a type of earthworm for composting, which can help in breaking down this waste. There are different types of composting. You know, behind Nilgiri, there's a biogas plant. Did you all know that? Yeah. Behind Nilgiri, the training school hostel is there. No, Mahapik biogas plant. It's underground. So you know what they do? They take wet waste and they put it inside the biogas plant and they keep it closed, right? And then when the composting happens and all the material, it decays and everything, it produces a gas. It produces a mixture of gas, but that gas is called biogas, and it's a very good fuel. You know, I don't know if any of you stays in Nilgiri or have ever stayed in Nilgiri. Once in 6 months or once in a year, you will get this very bad smell that comes. That is when they open the biogas plant and you get that smell. You understanding? But such initiatives are happening in our colony. But this composting can be done in your house also. You know, every day some wet waste is produced. So you can just put it in that thing and you can keep it in the balcony. It need not be in your house also. You can keep it in your balcony. And then after like a month or month and a half, you can just open it, take it, put it for your plants. Your plants will also prosper and there is no waste created. Isn't it? And finally, you plant trees or you plant many trees. So I don't know who stays in Ragmala. So at the end of Ragmala, right, I think the building is called Lalit, right? Uske piche there is like a ground, and on the borders of the ground you have these palm trees. They are all planted in a line. You know, there are these palm trees right at the end of Ragmala, just before the North Gate, next to the building called Lalit, that you have these palm trees that are planted. One of these trees was planted by me. So you know, those trees were planted on the occasion of Van Mohotsav, or I think it was World Environment Day. World Environment Day is celebrated on 5th June, right? When I shifted to Ragmala, Ragmala had just been made, you know. So we were among the first people to live in Ragmala. So at that time, those trees were never there also. And for the World Environment Day, all of us gathered at the Lalit ground and they had these saplings of palm trees, you know. And we actually planted them. So I think towards the road, towards the main road, I think the third palm tree is planted by me. So, you know, we used to do all this. So you can take initiative like that. You can plant trees and you can adopt a tree, you know. That is tree ko water karne ka and everything ka responsibility is mine. So you take responsibility only for one tree and that is also enough. Isn't it? Now, one example I can give you is this town which is called Biachi. We don't even have to look at other countries, you know. So this town called Diat is a small town in Mizoram and it has been awarded the best city award like multiple times, you know. So what these people do is that every Saturday in the morning, young children, they will come out and they will clean just their neighborhood, just the area surrounding their house. They will sweep it, they'll clean it, whatever kachra is there, they'll pick it up, throw it in the dustbin. And then on every Sunday or Monday, there'll be a big truck that comes, they'll collect this kachra and they'll take it away. That is all. That is all these people do, and it is one of the cleanest towns in the country. Isn't that inspirational? And it is young children who are actually spearheading this. So, and also every resident has decided to contribute some amount. So what they contribute is 50 rupees per month, you know, towards keeping their own town clean. So they take initiatives like that. I think that is a very good thing. But this town is still very far away. It is in Mizoram, right? Mizoram doesn't even have that much population. This town of Biat has a population of 2,500, which is probably not even the population of 2-3 buildings in our colony. But then there is another example in our city itself. You know about Vasova Beach cleanup, right? It was the largest beach cleanup in the entire world. Not even the country, but the entire world. So Vasova Beach used to be a dump yard. It used to be so dirty, there was no place to work. If you wanted to work, you had to step on plastic bags that were filled with God knows only what, you know. But this one fellow who goes by the name Afroz Shah, he took initiative and he started this thing called Vasova Beach Cleanup, where he used to come along with a few of his friends, and then more and more people saw this and they joined them. Now these are common people. They are not really people who are probably officials, or they don't work with BMC or anything. They're just common people who decided on a Sunday to dedicate 1 hour, 1.5 hours to clean their own city. And little by little, it took a long time, right? But they cleaned the entire beach. So you can see the before and after photos, right? There is a tremendous difference. And guess what happened? The next year, there were these turtles called Olive Ridley turtles that actually laid eggs on the beach, and there were hatchlings. There were hatchlings that were on the beach after many, many years. Because of the dirt, Olive Ridley turtles had stopped coming to the beach. And after the beach cleaned up, nature itself adopted the beach again.
So, first of all, let me thank you, Dr. Ashwari and Dr. Divya Naik, for the very informative and topical lecture. The lecture was indeed very enlightening and enjoyable. I'm sure our students will benefit greatly from the wisdom of these experienced doctors. Let me take this opportunity to express my heartfelt gratitude to Sri B. Venganna, our principal, Atomic Energy Center School No. 2, for giving permission to organize the lecture on personal and civic hygiene as a part of the observance of Swachhata Pakhwada. I also thank Srimati Padmalata, our headmistress, Srimati Geeta Nair, CCA in charge, all teachers and non-teaching staff of Atomic Energy Center School No. 2, Mumbai. They had extended every possible help to conduct this program and make it a success. Let me also mention sincere gratitude to the parents of the students who have participated in this session. Last but not least, let me wish all student participants of this program and all the best in their future endeavors. Thank you, one and all. And still, if you have got any doubt, once the school reopens, we will meet and we will discuss this.